Hey, how's it going everyone? MLT Magic Tricks here. So in this video, I'm going to be revealing Ryan Trick's audition from America's Got Talent. He performed a series of magic tricks on Simon and Howie, and I'm going to be breaking down how he did those in this video today. And if you guys have not seen the performance already, I will be leaving the link in the description to it. And if you are new here to the channel, make sure you subscribe with those post notifications on for more videos like this. And also, check out the link in the description to my Amazon page, where I have a collection of all the decks I use in my videos, along with a variety of magic tricks and accessories. Now guys, let's get straight into this reveal. Okay, so I'm first going to explain the setup that Ryan has in both of the decks that he used for this trick, and then I will get into the hand-raising part, and the final part of the trick, where Howie guess the object of a cookie. So let's get right into the setup that Ryan is going to have in both of the decks that he's using. And also, guys, everything I explain in this video is by no means 100% correct. This is my theory based on the evidence that was given in the video. So just keep that in mind. Now let's get right into it. So the decks that Ryan used for this trick, they are going to have a bunch of duplicate five of clubs. Now, I have a deck here that's going to emulate what his deck is going to look like. Pretend all the clubs that you see here on the bottom portion are duplicate five of clubs. He's going to have around 20 or so. So I took, 13 clubs from this deck and then just some from another deck to have around 20. The bottom portion of cards, they are all going to be the duplicate five of clubs. The top portion, these are going to be random cards. And the very bottom most card is going to be a random card as well. So he's ultimately going to be forcing, the five of clubs onto Simon and Howie. And I'm going to explain how he is going to do that based off of the setup in his decks. That is going to look something just like this. And he's also going to memorize the card that is directly above this section of duplicates. So in this case, the four of diamonds. The four of diamonds would be his key card in this setup. He's going to memorize, a key card in both of the decks. And I'll explain why right now. So he takes the deck out of the box, and he's first going to show everyone that the cards are different. Now, the way the deck is set up allows him to show the top portion of cards, and it makes it seem like all of the cards in the deck are different. And as he's spreading them out, he's going to stop once he gets to this key card right here, the four of diamonds, because he's going to be showing them the top portion of cards, and he's going to have a stack of cards here on the bottom. These are all going to be the duplicates, and then the random card here on the bottom conceals the section of five of clubs he has in the deck. So he's going to spread out the deck like this. And guys, I didn't do it perfect there. He's obviously going to practice a bunch before he goes up and performs it to everyone, but this is how it's going to look. This is basically the idea of the setup of his deck. So he's going to spread out the cards like this. He's going to stop at that key card, the four of diamonds. He's going to give everyone a quick glance. He asks, Howie and Simon for their respective decks. Are all these cards different? They say yes. He squares up the cards like this. He did not flash any of the five of clubs there. And then you'll notice he's going to spread the cards face down. So he turns over the deck. He's spreading the cards face down. He's going to spread out those 20 or so five of clubs. And then he's going to leave a clump of cards here on top that are all the random cards. As you guys can see here, the top portion of cards, these are all the random cards. And the cards that are on the table, the ones that Howie and Simon could stop over, these are all of the five of clubs. So at this point, all these face down cards are spread out. Everyone thinks these are random cards. Now, at this point, with the decks set up like this, Ryan is going to have Howie and Simon raise their finger over this portion of cards, and he's going to tell them to stop anywhere. Wherever Howie and Simon stop, they are always going to land on a five of club, no matter where they stop in this section, because he is only going to be spreading out the section of cards that have the five of clubs there. That's just a clever way of making it seem like all of the cards are different, but in reality, he is really only allowing them to choose the card that he needs for the trick to work, which is the five of clubs. So I hope that makes sense. Both of his decks, remember, are going to have this setup. He's going to be very careful when he is initially spreading out the cards to not flash any of the five of clubs. And obviously in the video, we couldn't see that. He made it seem like all the cards are different. Many guys, and you can tell kind of from the video when he spreads out the cards, they really, it doesn't look like a full deck. It looks like, there's like half a deck, and then when he flips them over, he's going to be leaving a clump of cards there on top. Those are all the random cards, remember, and I'll include a screenshot right now from the performance. You guys can kind of see there's a clump of cards there on top. That is how he forced the five of clubs onto Howie and Simon. Now let's talk about the part of the trick where it seemed like Simon was controlling Howie and when he was raising his hand. And now this part of the trick basically relies on Ryan applying pressure, not on Howie's hand, but on his foot. So You guys will notice the setup for this trick with the cloth in front of the table. That was done for a reason, because he's going to need to conceal to everyone what he's doing under the table during this part of the trick. So he's first going to go over to Howie. He's going to tell them, okay, you can feel this pressure. It's going to seem like he's pressing down on just the back of his hand. He's going to be feeling that pressure the entire time. But while he's doing that, he's also going to be using his foot and just applying that down onto Howie's foot. So he's also going to be feeling pressure. And then when Ryan goes over to Simon, he's going to tell Howie, okay, when you feel this pressure raise, when you feel the pressure releasing, you're going to raise your hand. So at this point, Ryan has his foot down on Howie's foot, applying pressure. And then he's going to tell Simon to raise up his hand. And as Simon does that, Ryan is going to be releasing the pressure off of Howie's foot. And that is going to cause him to raise his hand up just like that. And the same thing for when Howie pushed his hand down. Ryan went back to Howie's foot and applied pressure down like that, just, you know, slowly. So Howie would then slowly raise his arm back down to the table. And he, you know, synced it perfectly with the motions that Ryan was doing with moving his hand up and down. So Howie's would follow along with when he had Simon do it. When he had Simon, you know, raise up his hand, Ryan was releasing pressure off of Howie's foot. So that is the pressure that Howie was feeling. And, you know, he wasn't doing some secret thing with, you know, touching Howie's hand, because obviously we can see from the camera angles and everything that he was not, you know, touching any of his upper body or his hands. It was happening under the table with Ryan's foot pressing down on Howie. So, you know, that part of the trick is not too complicated. It's just, you guys, you know, have to remember everything in magic, you know, happens for a reason. And the setup there that Ryan had was done for a reason. So that black cover was covering what was happening below the table with Ryan's foot applying pressure onto Howie's. So that is the second part of the trick. And I'm just going to talk briefly about the final part where Howie guessed the cookie. Obviously, Howie had a blindfold on, so he was not able to see what Simon took. I'm sure there wasn't any pre-show work done either, or Ryan told Howie just to say cookie. That wouldn't really be fair. So there are, you know, obviously 5 senses, and I believe the sense that Ryan tapped into for Howie to say the word cookie was his sense of smell. So you will notice Ryan in the trick, he had a bowl of cookies. They were, you know, those small cookies, and I'm sure he did something to them to really radiate a smell coming from the box so that Howie could smell the cookies, whether it was like some chocolate scent he sprayed into the box, some cookie smelling scent, just something like that. So Howie would get in his mind to say the word cookie so the trick would work. Most plausible explanation, in my opinion, is having some really strong scent radiate from the box just so that it seems like he's smelling chocolate or, you know, vanilla or something like that. So he will guess cookie, and the trick works out, you know, perfectly at the end with Simon holding a cookie and then Howie blindfolded and he correctly guesses it. So it seems like Simon and Howie have some crazy connection. So guys, that's basically the trick. That's the entire reveal. I hope everything I explained made sense. Remember, everything I talked about in this video is by no means 100% correct. This is my theory and speculation based off of what was given in the video. Definitely give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new for all of the America's Got Talent reveals. Thank you for watching. I will see you all in the next one. Peace out.